Good morning, everybody. I will talk about the metabolomic characterization of patients affected by relapsing-remitting and primary progressive multiple sclerosis. Multiple sclerosis is an inflammatory neurodegenerative chronic disease of the central nervous system, with a high incidence in young adults, characterized by high levels of heterogeneity in pathological, clinical, and radiological features, as well as drug responses. Actually, the lack of a single predictive or diagnostic test remains a great obstacle in the management of the multiple sclerosis. And moreover, the study of the pathophysiology of the multiple sclerosis through the metabolomics approach may have important implications for identifying new therapeutic targets. Today, I show you the results of the analysis of a cohort of patients affected by relapsing remitting and primary progressive multiple sclerosis, two types of this disease, in order to find potential biomarkers to distinguish the two forms of multiple sclerosis. For this aim, a total of 34 patients were enrolled in the study, and for each patient, we analyzed both cerebrospinal fluid and serum samples. All the samples were analyzed through different analytical platforms, such as nuclear magnetic resonance and GCMS in Cagliari, while an aliquot of samples was analyzed through the absolute IDQP 180 kit of Biocrates Life Science Company. All the data were organized in metrics which underwent the statistical analysis, both multivariate and univariate analysis, and the most important metabolites responsible of the separation between the classes of patients were analyzed through the meta-analysis software to find to give a possible biological interpretation of the data. Unfortunately, both the analysis with the nuclear magnetic resonance and with the GCMS did not allow to identify a specific metabolic fingerprint of the relapsing remitting and the primary progressive patients. And so we focused our attention on the results from the bioprotest analysis. In this slide, you can see the result of the supervised models of the comparison between samples belonging to the two different classes generated by the metrics from the bioprotest analysis. And these analytical platforms provided the analysis of several classes of metabolites, and in particular, in panel A and C, you can see the results of the analysis of the phosphocholines, lysophosphatidylcholines, and sphingolipids. While in panel B and D, you can see the result of the analysis of the hydrophilic substrates, such as amino acids and biogenic amines. Moreover, you can see that both the analysis of the cerebrospinal fluid and the blood samples generate a good models, where samples are differently clusterized on the basis of belonging to the specific class. And it is also proved by the statistical parameters which are reported in the table below. Several metabolites were found changed in the different classes of patients. And this panel represents a summary of the old trends. And in particular, here are presented the box plot of the most discriminant hydrophilic and lipophilic biomolecules resulting from the analysis of the two biofluids. The most important metabolites which passed the homoferroni correction, and so we showed a p-value minor than 0.05, were used to perform the pathways analysis through the metaboanalysis software. And we try to give a possible biological interpretation to some of the most altered pathways. And in particular, glutathione metabolism and nitrogen metabolism are closely linked to the oxidative stress. Oxygen and nitrogen free radicals may represent important features in the pathogenesis of multiple sclerosis. And the fundamental role of oxidative stress in multiple sclerosis has been proved by several scientific studies. And it's important moreover, it has been proposed that reactive nitrogen species promote myelin and oligodendrocyte destruction due to their cytotoxic effect of nerve and glial cells. And moreover, Unbalancing glutamate metabolism seems to be putative in the investigation of the primary progressing form of multiple sclerosis, and this causes several damages in neurological tissues based on the excessive stimulation of glutamate receptors and subsequent excitotoxic injury of neurons and glial cells, as previously widely demonstrated. And finally, phenylalanine, tyrosine, and tryptophan biosynthesis was an altered pathway from the analysis of the cerebrospinal fluids. And we found that tryptophan is closely linked to the kynurenine pathways that is activating a number of inflammatory neurodegenerative disease. And so we can conclude that the metabolomics approach allowed the identification of specific metabolic features by studying plasma and cerebrospinal fluid samples of affected patients among different phenotypes of multiple sclerosis. And finally, alteration of pathways linked to the presence of oxidative stress and the alteration in the tryptophan metabolism seems to be crucial in the metabolic profile of patients affected by primary progressive multiple sclerosis compared with the relapsing-remitting forms, suggesting a possible target to explore. Thank you for your attention.